Well, it's been a turbulent few days for Qantas, with former CEO Alan Joyce stepping down yesterday, 2 months ahead of schedule. Vanessa Hudson now finds herself in the big seat with plenty to do to resurrect the reputation of the flying kangaroo. Checking her baggage and taking to the skies to give us her take on all things Qantas is the oracle of everything, Mel Buttle.
Thank you.
Hey Mel, you're a bit of a fan of Qantas. What do you love about the airline?
I love the older mumsy style people on the cabin crew. I want an old cabin crew. I want them to have to put their bifocals on to check my boarding pass, you know? I want it to feel like we're in a Sky version of a Miller's store up there. I just love them old, you know, sue me. I want to be served by cabin crew who would order their coffee like this. I'll have a skinny flat white, extra, extra hot with a quarter of a sugar. Like, they're just my people because, you know, and I'll say this, what if, and God forbid, there was an emergency and the plane came down? Wouldn't you rather much be lost on a desert island with Glenda Dot and Maureen? I know I would. Imagine being stuck marooned with the 21-year-old hosties. They'd be like, oh, my God, waiting to be rescued is not giving slave vibes, Queen.
So, Mel, does this desire for older staff stretch to the pilots?
Of course, yes, it does, Hamish. Yes, please. No young pilots. If you still wear Lynx deodorant, if you've never had a colonoscopy or you know who or what the hell a Demi Lovato is, I'm hopping off, actually. And first officers, I do make an exception. They can be young. That's fine. I don't really know what they do up there, but I assume it's like, you know, when you're on a big long road trip and dad's driving and mum like feeds lollies in his mouth. That's what I picture.
Now, Qantas has come under fire for losing customers' baggage. Do you have any advice for the new CEO?
Yes, I do, Boy George. Thank you so much for the question. Losing bags. Or are they simply rehoming your bag? Life is all about perspective. And the solution, I think, is staring us in the face. Ban bags. You heard me. If people are going to obsess over their bags and not be able to cope without your clothes and your medication and a phone charger for a couple of minuscule little weeks in India, then leave your precious bags at home where they are safe, please. Don't go taking them on a flight.
Well, Mel, you're an ideas person. I know that about you. Qantas is a business. Do you have any ideas how Qantas could increase profits, maybe by offering some new services?
Yes. Yes, I do, Samuel. I've gone through Qantas's books with a fine-tooth comb this afternoon. Look, I understand business. I've worked at the Woolworths Deli for 6 months. I get it, right? I've got some product innovations that I'd like to present here on this platform. Firstly, how about this? No middle seats for life, $5,000.
Well, that's good. I like that.
Yeah, that's good. If you want an in-flight magazine without the crossword done, that's $15. I'm sorry, it's how it is, right? If you want to make an announcement on the PA, $400. And if you want to fly the plane, $10,000.
Mel Buttle, check your emergency exits. They are here and here. Thank you so much for your insight.
You're too good at that, Sarah. Thank you.